Hi guys, I'm here in front of the Sacred Heart Basilica in Richmond, Virginia, and I'm going to talk to Daniel Sañez, director of music, who presides a very exciting organ project in this cathedral, installing two large organs in a 19th century French tradition. And one of the two organs has been installed this year. And we are going to talk about the project and see the organ and see the basilica. So let's go meet Daniel. Hey Daniel,
Finally.
How are you?
Welcome, good morning.
Good
Welcome.
To see you.
Long time no see indeed. Welcome to the Cathedral of the Sacred Heart. This is a building that was dedicated in 1906 on Thanksgiving Day. That date was chosen specifically to show the compatibility of American society and Catholic life. Because at the time in Virginia, the environment for Roman Catholics was not very friendly. So they chose that date on purpose to show one could be a patriot and also remain a Roman Catholic.
Let's go see the organs inside.
Please.
Wow, it's so beautiful. Could you tell me more about the organ project? As I understand, you have these two organs already installed, what we are about to see, but there is an ongoing project of a new organ for the back of the church in the gallery.
That's correct. So let's start with these instruments up here. When I first arrived at this cathedral about 7 years ago, people asked me what I thought of the organ. I gave them my honest opinion, which was not too favorable about that organ there in the back. And they asked if I knew some organ builders in this net, and I said, sure, yeah, I do. If you're interested in that kind of thing, go this way. We knew we needed to replace that organ. The committee members wanted a front organ, so we said, let's make a comprehensive project. And I said, since we're doing all of this stuff, why don't we throw in a third organ, the Continuo organ, since so many ensembles who perform here always ask for one. I always thought it might be nice for the cathedral to have a small instrument like this, and it's been very helpful to us. So lo and behold, we got three, much to our surprise. We
thought. So what is the timeline for the large organ?
It's coming in 2 years. April 2024 will be the installation, and we hope to be finished with the voicing by the fall of that year. Mm-hmm. So between April and September of 2024, the new organ will be here, and it'll be voiced and ready to go for the fall.
And the organ builders are?
Juget-Sinclair of Montreal, Quebec, Canada.
So here is the little Continuo organ. Mm-hmm. I see that it has some, are these principal pipes in the front?
Yes, this is the wooden principal in the front. There's a little bas-relief underneath the second set of facade pipes that depict the Sacred Heart of Jesus, the initials of Christ. And then on the far right is a bunch of crosses.
Bourdon 8.
Mm-hmm.
flûte 4. De Bourdon. At the principal 8. The principal 4, principal 8, and the 4-foot flute together. Let's add the 2-foot principal. See that this organ doesn't have a facade speaking into the nave. It speaks to the apsis right here.
Yes,
correct. And to the back of the church.
Speaking directly across here in the ambulatory, and also there's a facade on this side, which is the flûte harmonique. This front here is the monte, the principal, and on the side there's the flûte harmonique.
And there's nothing on the floor level except I saw some trombone stops. Oh, those are wooden resonators, so it's probably in the more Germanic tradition, right?
That's correct. More Germanic tradition.
Speaking of a melting pot of an organ.
Yeah, that's right.
So Germanic trombone, and other reeds are, I presume they are French reeds?
They are certainly, yes.
Yeah, great. Mm-hmm. How do you access that upper level?
Good question.
It's a secret door.
You see it drop down? And you have access to the case from there.
Oh, so it's like a balanced swell box.
It is.
You just handle that lever.
Right here.
Yeah.
I don't know if...
Can I try?
If our friends can come over and see.
There's a lever. And what should I do? Just try to lift it and...
Lift it and pull toward you. And let it go down.
Uh-huh. So it automatically closes.
That's brilliant.
Thank you.
We wanted a choir organ to be able to accompany the choir, who occasionally sings here. Without the use of the gallery organ, the choir is now exclusively located on the opposite side of the console. And so we wanted to be able to have an instrument that could accompany Howells, Perry, Fauré, any of those composers, and be successful at it. We also needed an interim instrument. So without the gallery organ, this instrument needed to be able to accompany the assembly with hymnody and the singing of the ordinary and all of these kinds of things. So hence, it is a little bit larger than a typical choir organ. It's 21 stops as opposed to the bare essentials being 11, 12 stops, things like that. So the purpose of this instrument is twofold: to accompany the choir and also to accompany the assembly. So a typical Sunday morning when there's plenty of people, you might hear something like this. Example, when accompanying the choir, you know, there's this sound here. Etc. So those are some nice flutes. Obviously, that's a little excerpt played improperly from the Fauré Requiem in Paradiso movement. Also, you know, there's this schematic that I used too. So
that was the oboe with the bourdon. Yeah,
and the dulcian. Yeah, I find that the principle with in terms of accompanying the choir can be just a little bit too dominant. So oftentimes I'll substitute the principle with just the 8-foot string, the 8-foot flute, and the great.
Thank you. What, do you have any favorite combinations, favorite stops?
I have several favorite stops. One being this harmonic flute, of course. And I also like this principle, of course. You already heard it earlier. And there's some other combinations I really enjoy, such as the swell gambe with the 4-foot or the 2-foot, the gambe with the 4-foot and sometimes the 2-foot also. It's very helpful. It's also very nice. There's a beautiful principal chorus as well here. And then, of course, all the foundations drawn together is very satisfying, with or without the principal and the grade. Thank you.
Prestons 4. Without the cant. Trombone. The Bourdon 8. Flûte traversière. Thank you. Octaviant. Paired with the flute traversière on the canto. The swell box is really effective. The Voix Celeste with the gamba. Basson au bois on the récit by itself. Trompette.
Mm-hmm.
Caron. With the trumpet. De basson. With the plunger. Really effective, incredible. Octava with the corps de nuit. De flûte octaviante. Haven't heard a gamba by itself.
Humidity is bad, the wood will make the action go up. So these are loose right now. Yeah. And then when the organ is off, these are loose. And then when you turn the wind back on, they stay in place like this so that the action is always perfect.
And then let's hear the trumpet and oboe solo.